Hey all, welcome to Share Trek. This is your host Raj here, and today with me I have my dear little Corey. She's not feeling well, so she's a bit clingy today and she wants to stay with me, so I hope you don't mind. Let's get started. Today I want to talk to you about a couple of things. It's all coherent because I want to attempt a status update on EBT 101, which is very difficult to do because not much information is available. And I also want to take the opportunity to explain why HIV is challenging even for EBT 101. So with that said, let's get started. Welcome back, friends. First, a little background. HIV is a single-stranded RNA genome, but during replication within the host cell, it converts to a double-stranded DNA using an enzyme called reverse transcriptase. The key player is the HIV enzyme called integrase. Integrase makes the blunt-ended cuts in both strands of the viral DNA, meaning the ends are straight, not staggered, and integrase then proceeds to process the ends of the viral DNA and integrates it into the host cell cell's DNA at the target site. This process might involve some minor modification to the human DNA to facilitate integration, but it doesn't do a single strand or a double strand cut. It just joins the HIV DNA to the human genome. That's all. The integration could happen anywhere on the DNA. But HIV prefers area where there is high chromatin so that it can still be active. It prefers areas of the chromosomes where there are a lot of active genes which are being transcribed so that it can start replicating. Even within preferred regions, the specific point of integration might be somewhat random due to the chance encounter between the viral DNA and the host cell's DNA. A single cell can be infected by multiple HIV variants. So a single strand of host DNA can have multiple spots in which HIV variants have integrated. So each virus might integrate at a different location within the host cell's genome. So this is the scope of the problem, my friends. I hear many people on the comments saying, why is not a cure found so far? It's almost so many years, 40 years, and no cure has been found. Companies are all trying to make money and this and that. But that's not true. It's a very, very difficult disease to cure. And research hasn't shown a clear preference for HIV to integrate to a particular chromosome. The integration sites can be spread across all of human chromosomes. So we have 23 chromosomes, we have homologous pairs. It could go and integrate anywhere. Studies do indicate a bias towards integrating near actively transcribed genes and areas with an open chromatin structure. Chromatin is needed for unwinding and replicating. These regions are found throughout the human genome, not limited to specific chromosomes. And newer approaches like EBT-101 utilize CRISPR to target the viral DNA. However, the dispersed nature of the provirus makes it challenging to ensure complete eradication. But given the guide RNA looking for the same address can be found in a single cell, in a single DNA, if there is multiple HIV infections. So to that extent, CRISPR-Cas9 is potent, and therefore EBT-101 is potent, but it has to find and make those cuts. And HIV has a high mutation rate, allowing it to develop resistance to treatment over time, but EBT-101 is targeting areas which are relatively less mutating, and therefore it's more likely than not to find and excise the part of HIV that can prevent it from replicating. EBT-101 uses CRISPR-Cas9 with two guide RNAs, but it doesn't aim to remove the entire gag gene. I used to tell before, I did more reading, and it seems that it's not trying to remove the entire gag gene. It targets three specific locations within the HIV genome. These sites are strategically chosen to excise a large segment of proviral DNA, rendering the virus incapable of replicating. While some of the depleted region might overlap with parts of the gag gene, eliminating the entire gag gene isn't the primary goal. Disrupting multiple essential viral elements is a more effective approach to ensure HIV cannot function and HIV cannot replicate. And damaging the gag protein itself is sufficient because the entire gag chain will not be formed, and therefore all the parts that is needed to build the HIV virion will not be available. So EBT-101 clinical trials, numbered as EBT-101-001, was a first-in-human open-label sequential cohort, single ascending dose study of EBT-101. And it was planned to be administered intravenously to approximately 9 viremic HIV-1 infected adults on stable antiretroviral therapy. That has been done. On day one, eligible participant received a single IV dosage of EBT-101, and all participants were planned to be assessed for eligibility of an ATI or analytical treatment interruption of their background, suspending their background ART at week 12. All participants will be followed throughout week 48. And participants who undergo ATI will have more frequent study visits than non-ATI participants. Eligible participants who are enrolled in that study were also to be enrolled in a separate long-term follow-up study called EBT-101-002 for safety monitoring. The duration of the long-term follow-up study was supposed to be 15 years. That long-term follow-up study is still ongoing, and we don't have any data from there. The data from the first dose cohort included positive safety and biodistribution data up to 48 weeks, and the company reported no serious adverse events or dose-limiting toxicities in any of the first three trial participants dosed with EBT-101, and that EBT-101 could be detected in the bloodstreams of those three trial participants was also confirmed. Based on these data, the company planned to initiate testing the next dose cohort in Q4 2023, and it expected to present further clinical data this year in 2024. I could not find any information about this, but I just know that the long-term follow-up of the first 9 patients is still ongoing and no adverse effect has been reported so far. So we should expect some data release later this year, or if there are any conferences, we might probably get some information from those conferences where Excision presents. So that is the status. Now I want to show you a few slides to illustrate some of the points so that you could understand it. So I just have this conceptual slides out here. This is how AGT-103 works. So you take out the blood from the patient and isolate the CD4 T cells and delete the CCR5 gene so that the CD4 T cell cannot express CCR5. And then make sure that the CD4 T cell are CCR5 negative, multiply them and reinfuse them into the body of the patient so that these cells will not be attacked by HIV. HIV can't get into them. And these CD4 T cells will command the CD8 plus T cells and the other immune cells to attack and kill HIV. So that's the plan with AGT-103-T. Next, we look at EBT-101. And the way I would say this is that EBT-101, as you see, this big circle shows scissors cutting DNA. It's a very simplistic approach, but as I mentioned to you, the cuts are going to happen in 3 spots. And those cuts cumulatively will take out a huge portion of HIV, which is essential for it to replicate. And these cuts are designed to happen in the location of the HIV DNA, which do not mutate too much because they are very essential for the functioning of HIV. And therefore, it will render this entire embedded HIV DNA totally useless and unable to produce a functioning HIV virus. And the way it is done is that the CRISPR-Cas9 with 2 guide RNAs is loaded into adeno-associated virus, and it's injected into the patient's body, and that's how it is done. So you can always pause this screen and read what I have got here. It is the explanation that I made to you. There are 2 types of cell in a HIV-infected patient. Now, this CD4 T cell is also infected, and so is this. Both have got HIV in them, but this one is RNA positive because you will see there is a HIV RNA floating around. These could have been replicated from the HIV provirus, which is in the host genome, and then they become virions and they become HIV virus particles and come out. And there are HIV protein within this CD4 T cell, Whereas in this particular CD4 T cell, even though it is infected, it doesn't have HIV RNA and it doesn't have any HIV protein, because the HIV is dormant in this, it is latent, it's not creating viruses. And therefore, this is going to be difficult for any HIV therapy to detect. So as a result of all this thing, you now would understand how difficult it is to cure HIV. And I do feel for anyone who is suffering from HIV, but there are a lot of people who have taken HIV very positively and in their stride and have not refused to challenge all the goals that they are looking for in their life. They have not allowed HIV to dominate, because HIV is not only a physical game, but it's also a mental game. And more so, I think it's a mental game, because on the physical side, you can't do anything. You can just take ART. That's about it. Regardless of how much mental gymnastics you do, the therapy is not going to get delivered ahead of schedule. And the HIV virus cannot be willed away, because it's a physical reality. It's there. But agonizing over HIV is not going to change the status, make it go away quicker or get any worse. But focusing on career goals, focusing on life goals and working towards it, focusing on your profession, all those things could be a very positive way of taking it. But friends, it's easier said than done for someone who doesn't have HIV. For those who have HIV, it's very difficult knowing that there is a virus which is working away inside the body. They can do nothing about it. So I understand where you're coming from, but I wanted to explain to you why it is taking so much time, because I can sense the frustration among so many people in the channel that they have been waiting for 40 years and nothing has come out. But this is the reason why, because the HIV virus is just hell-bent on replicating. And as you saw, in a single host genome, HIV can attach into multiple places. So there'll be multiple copies of HIV within the same CD4 T cell. So we need to excise all of them. And then it gets dormant, so you can't find it. So we need to have the kick and awaken kind of agent that can reactivate all those dormant HIV and make those cells start generating virions so that they can be targeted and killed and they become visible to the therapy. So we now have agents which can actually activate dormant HIV and make them visible to the therapy. We have got ART, which is very, very effective. And we have got two strong gene therapies that are working in the clinical trial. One is EBT-101 and the other is AGT-103-T. And we are also developing broadly neutralizing antibodies. They are on clinical trials. And then we have ASC22 with chidamide, which has already proved itself against hepatitis B. And it's in test for HIV. So all these things are ongoing, and all of these therapies can only see the active cells and attack them. So we need to use them along with the kick and start kind of therapy. So there are two trials going on along with HIV. I don't know whether they're official trials or not, but the test is being done to see if HIV, latent HIV, can be awakened and EBT-101 can go and excise it. So we'll find more details about that. It's very difficult to come by information. I'm trying my best, so please be patient. Please stay tuned. And if you find any information anywhere, do share. There's Mr. Majestic who shares information from time to time, because sometimes I might miss out on the information because I'm not only following HIV, but I'm also following a whole bunch of genomic therapies which are going on in my genomic investment section. So sometimes I might miss something. That's why I have decided that I'm going to compulsorily cover each of these therapies once every month, so that I can catch up on anything that is happening. So there'll be a bit of redundance, but I'm going to add more information like I did in this video, so that there is some value add for you. My friends, so with this, I would like to bring this video to an end. And those of you who can become a member, I have introduced a new $2.99 subsidized member membership level. Please become a member or become a Patreon for the channel. The link is all in the description, so you can join for us. Join us to become either member or Patreon and support this channel to continue bringing you latest HIV videos like this one. With this, I would like to bring this video to an end. Thanks and have a great day, my friends. I'll catch up with you again in the next video. Till then, stay safe. Bye for now.